Disappointment rears its ugly head again, a debilitating blow as the day begins. Imagined flaws could not be any clearer. Every bitter word spoken spills out on the mirror. Something you're born with, unique and inherently in your bones. A creature created like no other being, because if you were, we'd all be merely clones. And if we're all beautiful by nature because of difference, to change who we are by an inch is without sense. Why strive for some impossible standard of supposed perfection that is learned, leaving beauty and self in disconnection? Words so important, we are molding generations to believe that what's around them should be part of their own self-equations, giving credence to the boy on the bus who whispered she was fat, affirming that outspoken classmate who assured him he'd never amount to that. And it isn't much different in the world of sheltered at her home. If for a moment she thought she was beautiful, she might find herself completely alone. Because mommy, when you tell me how I'm beautiful just the way I am, I can't hear the words you're saying over your own attempted identity sham. Will tell them that they're beautiful just the way that they are. And we'll tell them that they're beautiful no matter weight, blemishes, sizes, or scars. But when the definitions we give them for perfection don't match up to their own perceived reflections, which in hindsight aren't enough, we are leaving our young people hurt and confused, pushed and pulled, marred and shoved, believing they alone aren't deserving of love. In fact, we hold the answers, and words and mirrors are all that must be subjected to change, be turned around, be spoken of differently, if only if just we and only we have the power to change the views of those around us, and by nature change the pain. The TV screens and magazines just strive to send out a different message. Mommy, can you hear me, or am I silenced in my adolescence? Because I can never be equated with the product of what the world says I am, but it's hard when pulled in so many directions to hold my own peace and break the dam. Because a mirror is not a place where self and false perceptions of beauty were meant to collide. Rather, it is inception of the vantage point where appearance is realized and stereotypes go to die. Because a person, man or woman, is not defined based upon the point of views of those around them. They were meant to soar their own direction and forget the expectations, solve their own conundrum.
The world has told me that I am a mistake.
The world tells me I need makeup.
The world tells me I'm fat.
I'm flawed.
Too short.
I look like a slut.
The world tells me my butt is too big.
The world tells me I should have a bigger butt.
The world tells me I need a thigh gap.
I need hair like a white person.
The world tells me I should be built.
The world tells me that I should have blonde hair and blue eyes.
The world tells me I should be thin.
The world thinks I'm ugly.
But I'm beautiful.
But I am beautiful.
But I'm beautiful.
I'm beautiful.
But I'm beautiful.
Beautiful.
But I'm beautiful.
But I'm beautiful.
But I'm beautiful.
But I think I'm beautiful.
But I am beautiful.